Hi, welcome to an AutoCAD 2017 video tutorial. I want to do the coupling with Draft, which I did before in all the other programs, now in AutoCAD. And I did it somehow different to other programs because it's AutoCAD. So let's have fun with AutoCAD. Okay, let's start with some sketches. I have some more layers as usual. I got two sketches layer, two solid minus, two solid plus, and two surfaces layer, and one curves layer. So at first I need some sketches. I will go for a circle, which should be at 0, 0, and the radius should be 25. Then I need another circle at 205, 0, and the radius would be 15. Now I want to make an extrude or two extrudes, so we'll go for solid plus layer, make an extrude with that circle right here, enter, and the distance should be 50 divided by 2, that's 25 minus 1, it's 24, and it should have a taper angle, and the taper angle should be 4. Should be 24. And another extrude over here. Taper angle should be 4 as well. And the height should be 14. Now let's move this up. So I want to move this one in that direction 1 millimeter. Okay, let's do another extrude with that circle. No taper angle, but the height should be 1 millimeter. Maybe let's change this to conceptual so you will see. Same over here. Move it up 1 millimeter. Make another extrude with a circle. With this one. And 1 millimeter height. Now let's make a union. Let's go for union. This body and that body, same over here, union, this body and that body. Okay, then I want to mirror those two bodies, so let's go for mirror, 3D mirror. I want to mirror this one and that one, and 3 points of the mirror plane are this point, that point, and this point. And no, very nice. Now let's make two more unions, this body and that body. Repeat, this body and that body. Enter. Check. This should be one body, yes. And I want to move this up a little bit. 60 difference is, so let's move this one up 60 millimeters. 60. But it should be vertical, so it's 60. Okay. And then that's too much. I have to move it down 15, I suppose. Yes. Well, let's wait and see if they're correct aligned. Let's go for another sketch. Maybe do it on the sketches two layer, or on the sketches one layer. That's okay. And hide the solids for the moment. Top. And I need a polyline, but I could do it with this one at first. So it should start right here, and it should go somewhere here, but with an angle, and the angle should be 4 degrees. So let's go for the angle 4, and maybe up to this one right here. Okay, I need the same line on the other side, so you could mirror it. Mirror this one and maybe like this. Sorry. Mirror that object from to that one and no. Then add those two lines and make it a polyline. Be edit, select one, join this one, that one, and this one, and confirm. It's a polyline. Okay. Now I want to extrude this. So go for extrude with this polyline. Enter, and let's make this 200. Okay. And you could use the same to the other side, another extrude. Again with that sketch right here, the polyline, and maybe in this direction your 100, and make a union, this one and that one, and move this to a different plane, maybe to the solid minus, because I want to do an intersection. So I go for solid minus. But I should select it and go for solid minus. Okay. Now I need another sketch. Let's hide this one and go for sketches 2, for example, and hide this solid minus. And I could also hide the sketches one layer for the moment. Okay. And I have to change my axis system. I want to rotate it around the x-axis. Okay. And now I can draw another sketch. This would be, I will go for a rectangle maybe. Or yeah. So that line, I need one line in the middle. Okay. So this should start at 0.15. In that direction it should be 46.7, then move down, that would be 30 in that direction, and then back here and close. So let's hide those parametric constraints. Now I need another sort of rectangle. So let's go for a line. You could do it with a rectangle as well, but in this case I prefer line. And it should be, the position should be 205 minus 42.4. Or let's start with 205. Yeah, 205 column, and that position would be 45 plus 45 plus 7, 45 plus 61. And it would go in that direction, 42.4, and then it would go up 16 over there and lows. This is kind of odd. Let's take a look at our bodies. So this should be not here, but this should be line. And it should be fifteen in that direction. Nope, got it wrong. So that's 16. That's 1. So 1 and then 9. 9, it should be 9, sorry. This is sometimes a little bit hard. So let's move those lines in that direction. 9. That's more like it. Okay, looks good. Now let's add a line from this point to that point, and from this point to that point. Okay, hide those constraints and maybe hide those solids. Solid plus, solid. Yeah. Now I need another line. Let's go for a line which should start at the midpoint here, go over there to the midpoint here, like this. Then I need a fillet or a round. So go for home round. Let's take a look. It's no trim, so go to trim. Yeah. The radius would be for the first one 25. And repeat the command on the second one would be 18, like this. I need a polyline, pedit, select one line, join this arc, that line, this arc, that line, right here. There should be a line, yes, and enter. So that's a polyline. Nice. Then I need another polyline, pedit, select that line, join this one, this one, that one, this one, that one, this one, and that one. Okay. Now I want to have an extrude. So go maybe for solid plus 2. Make an extrude with that sketch. Click in that direction, maybe 100. And in the other direction as well. Polyline. And in that direction 100. Make a union just for good measurement. Okay, now I can do an intersect with the solid minus with this one. Yeah, let's go for intersect this body and that body and confirm and move this maybe to a different layer, to solid plus 2. And let's check with our other bodies. Yeah, that looks good. So let's hide those bodies and switch to surface layer, surface 1, and hide those two bodies. Okay, now I want to make a surface extrude with that polyline right there. And again in both directions, in that direction maybe, yeah, 100, and in the other direction as well. Another extrude with that sketch, or you could extend, of course, that surface. Again 100. And let's join them by union. They will not be associative any longer, but that doesn't matter right now. Okay. And I need two offset surfaces. So maybe I go and put this into another layer. And maybe change the color of this one, make this one sort of yeah, like this. Then it's easier to see. Now I need an offset surface. So go for surface and make an offset from this one. in that direction 1 millimeter, and another one in the other direction, offset surface, flip direction, again 1 millimeter. Now let's hide surface layer 1. So, okay, seems I put all of them on the same layer, so let's just move this one to a different layer, to the second surfaces layer, okay, and let's hide. Go to solid plus, show this one, no, not this one, okay, and make it active layer and hide that layer right here. Okay, now I want to split this one, and I could do the fillets before or afterwards, doesn't matter, so I will do it before. So go to home, solid fillet edge, and the radius would be 10 on this edge and on that edge. Enter, enter, repeat, and radius now would be 40 on that edge right here. Enter, enter, and repeat, another radius, and that would be 26 up here. Enter, enter. Now let's split those bodies. Slice that body with this surface and keep both sides. So that's a body and that's one body. So I will slice the other body, this one. Again a surface, and that would be the second surface. Okay, now I could hide those surfaces. Okay, now I could hide the surfaces. That would be this one. No, it's hidden. Okay, now I got one body, two body, three bodies, and I want to have some curves. I could extract edges, but I would get edges, all the edges, or I could make offset edges. So I will go for offset edges and go to my curves layer, offset edge from this face, and the offset would be, the distance would be 0. And the same with the other surface, or I could have used, this was in the center, that would even be better. So let's use that surface, that's better. So go to offset edge, this surface, distance should be 0. Okay, now I could hide my bodies for a moment. Nope. Okay, and I want to use this lines to get my draft. I cannot draft it from a surface, so I do it in a different way. Let's check this. I could hide the sketches as well. To split this. So let's go for origin. Where's my origin? There is the origin command. And split it. Then I could just select this one, delete this, and again on the other end delete this as well. Nice. That's one curve, very nice. And that's one curve as well. So I could, you could use this as path for a sweep. Now let's turn our axis system around the y-axis by 90 degrees. Okay, and let's draw some lines with an angle. So go for line, and snap on that point, and maybe the length is, let's say, 40. The angle should be 86. Enter. Then need another line which starts right here, and again a length, but I want it to be parallel to this one, and length maybe, that should be enough. Okay, same procedure down below, but in the other direction. So let's go for another line, snap right here, now in that direction, and that would be, again, let's say 50, and the angle should be 180, that would be 0 in that direction. Let's take a look. In this coordinate system, that's 266. Nope. That's really amazing. So try once again, select that point, go in that direction, so this should be 86, so the length might be 50, and it jumps up. That's really crazy. That's take a look from the other side, then it should be possible to do it in the correct way. So select that point, and that the length should be 50, And the angle should be minus 86. Yeah. That's quite irritating. And another line, which starts right here and is parallel to that one. And the length might be, yeah, like this. Okay, now I can create two surfaces. And I will do it on the same layer. So go for surface, that would be a loft. First section, second section. Enter and use as guide that curve. Confirm. The same down below, loft, line, second line, and use as guide that curve. Enter. I want to have these two mirrored. So let's go for mirror, 3D mirror, this one, that one, and the mirror plane would be, of course, the three points of that plane right here. No, so I got it on the other side. Now let's show our solids. One, no, not freeze. One, two. And I need only the main body, that would be this one. Now I can split this body and that body with those surfaces. Or I could even make a union and then split it. Yeah, it should be possible, so go for union. One, two, three, one body, and now split it. Where is it? Solid slice, that body with that surface. And I want to keep this side. Repeat this one with that surface. Okay. Repeat body. Surface, keep this side, and again this body with that surface, keep this side. Now I could hide those curves layer, so let's switch to the body layer and hide that curves layer. See, you get a nice draft on these faces. Now I need some fillets, small ones, fillet, that would be a chain, and the radius would be 1 millimeter. Select this chain and that chain, enter, enter, repeat the command on this edge and that edge, enter, enter, and I need it again on the solid plus one objects. So another edge fillet, this edge, that edge, and enter, 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 this edge and that edge, enter, enter. Now let's hide the other bodies for a moment. Yeah, I cannot do fillet with variable radius, so I will use a constant radius. So go fillet edge again, it should be a chain, and let's go for I would go for 7, yeah, 7. Radius 7 on this one, enter, enter, repeat. Oh, it's almost too big, so maybe let's do it with a radius 6. Because it should not interfere with this one, so go for fillet chain radius 6 on that edge and on this edge as well. Enter, enter, and another fillet on that radius. It should be a chain again, and that radius might be 8 and 5. Let's go for 6, yeah, as well. Select it, and the other edge as well. Okay, enter, enter. Looks very nice. Now I could show the other solids. And let's make a union. Enter. That should be one body. Very nice. Some more fillets. Fillet, that would be another chain. Radius should be 6. Enter, enter, repeat. Another radius 6, hopefully it works, let's see. Yeah, and there should be a radius chain, and the radius should be 4. Select maybe. Enter, enter, and again, this edge and that edge, enter, enter. Maybe hide this raster. Yeah, looks very nice. Conceptual, go to realistic, it looks even better. Now I need two holes, and I could do this on a different layer. Let's say solid minus 1. And I use a cylinder. I can select that center, and the radius should be 15. Just move it down below. Same over here, another cylinder, select the center of that surface. Radius should be, let's check. Just move it down below like this, and now you could make a subtraction. So go for solid plus 1, make a subtract this object here, and these two should be subtracted, and I'm done. So if you want to see more AutoCAD videos, give it a like. If you liked it, give it a like. Leave, hopefully, a nice comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook cat fan page, and please like it as well. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.